I'm so excited to share with you guys my thoughts on the upcoming PvP changes to Final Fantasy XIV. If you guys hung out with us on the live stream, you know that that was a roller coaster of an emotions filled night with the delay of Endwalker and then going into PvP where they announced a battle pass. And at first my heart sunk, obviously, like introducing a kind of FOMO, fear of missing out piece of content is concerning to me as a player. Typically FOMO content does have me just say, you know, tip of the hat, I'll see you guys later. But in this case, the currency that you earn through it is still able to go back and get past rewards. You can save up for future rewards if you don't like the reward offering that's being applied. And so I think overall, this could be a really interesting concept to see if it provides to be, and it provides a rewarding and engaging piece of content regarding PvP. Hello, everyone. I guess we should just introduce this. Hello and welcome to the channel. My name is Brian. If you're new around here, for returning subscribers, you are smashingly smashing. That's what you get for subscribing, by the way. Free compliments at the start of these videos or somewhere like within the 1 minute mark of these videos. It is what it is, right? Anyway, guys, we're seeing a couple big changes. First and foremost, role-based matchmaking is going away. Role-based actions are going away. From the sound of it, it seems like everything's getting a little bit more normalized when it comes to what you are as in PvP, a DPS, right? A green DPS, a red DPS, a blue DPS. And hitting the mic, yay. But the outside of the role actions, that's actually one of the things we found that really did make the feast fun when running custom games. We found time and time again, whoever had the best healer was the team that won, hands down every time. And now, ultimately, you extrapolate that over 1,000, 10,000, obviously, there's going to be some variances in those numbers, but at the core, that's really what we kind of, you know, found out. We removed healers and the matches were back and forth. They actually introduced new strategy. And I know there's healers out there that would want to play that healing role within PvP. So we'll have to see how these changes actually shake out for the game. But also, I know there's a community that we definitely see them in the comments saying that we should just delete PvP and focus more attention on PvE. I think overall, the game's health is going to be, really reliant on both pieces of content. You don't have to have a PvP-focused MMORPG. Final Fantasy XIV doesn't really fit that. But PvP acts as a really good piece of content to also help offset gaps in PvE, in the curated content, because ideally, PvP is always changing. You're never going to run into the same group of people unless you're playing the Feast, like we did that one night where it was just the same party over and over again. But beyond that one, I guess hopefully outlier, the idea is that things are changing. You never can really know what to expect, and thus it's more engaging and fun. It's more sandboxy in a way. It allows you kind of play and experiment with more things. I think the biggest change overall outside of the roles things is going to a five-man party. We don't have five-man content in this game. I think we should. I would love to see them develop that. Sound off and let me know. Should we see more five-man content added? That's also for PvE content. I'd love to know. Like, no wrong answers here, just to see kind of where you fall. Because I always felt five-man seems to be the right number when it comes to roles and actions and content. We also have, obviously, eight-man content, which gives us a little bit more variety there. But five-man, at least for the light party, seems really interesting. And I'm excited to see that the PvP is kind of taking in that as its kind of base action. Now, I do want to talk about some of the things that I'd still like to see brought into PvP in the long run, but I think this is going to be really interesting just for the health of the game. Now, like I said, Battle Pass really originally sunk my heart, but the fact is that currency that you earn through it doesn't mean that the rewards expire. You just, it's a way to farm up the currency to get the rewards, and I'm going to have to play around with that and see how ultimately it makes me feel, because I think these are really big changes. The fact that Feast is going away, I do hope some of the work that they did, some of the UI, some of the, like when you knock somebody out, how the crowd cheers and things like that. Hopefully that comes into the Crystal Conflict mode. I think that's going to be really exciting to see for the long run and health of the game. And I'm nervous and at the same time hopeful that, especially when it comes to the Battle Pass style system, that it's going to be very rewarding. It's going to be very engaging. And if you got to take a break, you got to step away, you're not going to feel punished for doing so. I think Final Fantasy XIV has done a really good job and not artificially creating fear of missing out, that FOMO. I think that's a real detriment to games, is when you artificially make FOMO. FOMO is something that naturally happens, as an aspect of life, and I don't need it injected in from my video games, personally speaking. But the season and the series, this is where I think I'm really excited. seasons are going to be obviously focusing on Crystal Conflict. That seems to be their premier league of PvP for this game. But then you have series, and series, whether that, you know, has a multiple series per season, that actually having engaged in all of PvP, every piece of PvP, whatever you're doing, you're still working on your series. That I think is critical. I think that is so huge. And so I'm excited to see where they go from here. I hopefully we can get a good solid, you know, a foundation of PvP players to where when you want to PvP, you don't need to go out to a Discord or a Reddit or have to look at the calendar and time just to find a match. Hopefully with these changes and the role restriction being removed, that you can easily jump in and it's going to be like, yeah, we got games for days, guys. Let's go. Let's play. Let's have fun. Now, where do I want to see it go from here? What do I hope the future holds for this? Well, I would still love to see, like, obviously the PvP community grow. We've long wished that we could have some kind of world v world system from Guild Wars 2. I don't think they have to port it over directly, but ultimately finding that kind of balance in how you can keep things engaging and drive people into the game outside of the PvE updates and story. So I think first and foremost, I would love to see duels be able to be accessible anywhere in the world, maybe not in towns, but at least in the open world, that players could go and make their own matches and have their own rules. Now we'll have to see what happens with the Crystal Conflict, but it would be really cool to see one man 1v1 duels up to 5v5 duels out in the open world that players can set themselves. I think one of the things that hurts PvP in the community is how invisible it is. So one of the things I do want to do as a content creator and also as a fan of, you know, Final Fantasy, but as one of the things I want to do is that be able to hopefully really dive into Crystal Conflict when it launches here on the channel, so that way we can all sit down and play it together. So whether you like PvP or you don't, you know, if you're just interested in watching or if you want to participate, you're just nervous about doing so, hopefully we can get more people in to that kind of content so we can end up helping out and bolstering that community and making Final Fantasy 14 at least have more than just a checkbox on the list of features that they offer. Anyway, guys, I think these changes are really exciting. Just on paper alone, from what they showed off in the live letter, they look really powerful, and I can't wait to explore more. Thank you guys for your time, for your attention. Thanks for listening to me. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you feel like you earned it, hit that like button. Subscribe if you haven't already. Join the 24% of you who have subscribed, who watch these videos. I'll leave the choice up to you. Would appreciate you hitting that button. And also, that way you don't miss these videos. I usually upload every day for the most part. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoy. That's it for me, guys. You're awesome. Thanks for being around here. Hopefully you have a fantastic day. Hopefully I see you in my next video. But until then, take care.
I just want to say I'm really glad you're feeling better. And I love the videos. Well, I love you too. Michelle. Shoot for the moon, and so even if you fail, you'll reach the stars. Go for the 100,000 subscribers.